Hello again, everyone. Mark's here. I review stuff today. I'm reviewing the song Pretty Wings by Maxwell. This is part of my ongoing series where I'm listening to songs that come from albums that are on Rolling Stone magazine's list of the 500 greatest albums of all time. The way the series works is I'll make videos for two, maybe three songs on each album, and then eventually I'll go and listen to the rest of the album on my own. This song comes from number 467 on the list, which is Maxwell's Black Summer's Night, which re was released by Columbia in 2009. The year I graduated from high school. Wow, it feels like forever ago. And so, about the album, Rolling Stone says Maxwell was a successful 90s neo soul crooner who went on an 8-year hiatus between 2001's Now and this 2009 release. Black Summer's Night betrays no anxiety about the time off. In fact, it ranks among the great comeback records. Maxwell sang about post-breakup desperation as he navigated plush, complicated grooves with jazzy layers like Keon Harold and Derek Hodge, giving his arrangements extra zip. The album's ecstatic triumph is Pretty Wings, a keening, chiming lullaby. And that's the one we're doing today. So I say we jump right into it. Again, this is Maxwell, Pretty Wings. Let's do it. Literally starts out with a lullaby. Okay.
Time will bring the real end of our trial. One day there'll be no remnants, no trace, no residual feelings within you. One day you won't remember, man. Your face will be the reason I smile, but I will not see what I cannot have forever. I'll always love you. I hope you feel the same. Oh, you played me dirty. Your game was so bad. You toyed with my affliction, had to fill out my prescription. Found the way I'ma be. I had to set you free.
Oh,
yeah, it wasn't half bad. You know, when I hear, when I listen to songs like this one, as it kind of fades out here, listening to songs like this one reminds me of why I started this series, right? Because this is definitely not the kind of song I would typically listen to. Never really been a huge fan of like R&B, but I really like this, and so I want to start there. I really, really enjoyed this, but again, that's the whole reason I started this particular series, is because, I mean, most of my life, I grew up listening to rock, metal, stuff like that, and I still listen to mostly rock and metal, and if you see what gets requested most on my channel, it's rock and metal. And of course, there are very many different genres within rock and metal, right? I mean, you could take two artists that are both metal and they sound completely different, at least to someone who is a fan like me. But like, if I was only ever left up to my own devices, and I was only left up to just what people typically request on the channel, I would never hear stuff like Maxwell, like this song. And so again, it's just, I'm kind of rambling on, but essentially I'm really glad I decided to try out doing this series, because it's given me sort of a window to explore genres and artists that I don't think I would have otherwise ever come across. And artists that obviously people consider to be really, really talented and great. And again, this song was fantastic. So anyway, all that to say, really enjoyed this song. It was a fun chance to step out of my comfort zone. And explore a little bit more from an artist I've never heard before. So I say we break the song down like we always do, of course, starting with the lyrics. Keep bumping my table here, and my camera's like wibbly wobbly. I'm sorry for any wibbly wobblingness that keeps happening. Let's see. It does say here, I'm going to scroll down to the About section. It says, just in case there's more, in this song, Maxwell warns us about relationships in which feelings are somewhat forced rather than occurring naturally. Sure, let's read them and see if that's kind of how we understand it as well. So, time will bring the real end of our trial. One day there'll be no remnants, no trace, no residual feelings within you. One day you won't remember me. So, yeah, damn, I think he said it exactly clear as day there, right? Where at some point this relationship probably gonna end, right? Time will bring the real end of our trial. That or death, right? Like, time will bring about death, of course, and that's really the real end of all things for us, at least, right? One day there'll be no remnants, no trace, no residual feelings within you. One day you won't remember me. Your face will be the reason I smile, but I will not see what I cannot have forever. I'll always love you. I hope you feel the same. Oh, you played me dirty. Your game was so bad. You toyed with my affliction. I had to fill out my prescription. Found the remedy. I had to set you free, away from me, to see clearly the way that love can be. When you are not with me, I had to leave. I have to live. I had to lead. I had to live. To me, this sounds more like, again, he says here, you played me dirty. Your game was so bad. It sounds like a relationship that went south because maybe the other person was not faithful or not truthful or any other, you know, combination of things, and essentially having to sort of recover from that, right? That sort of prescription, the remedy, that kind of thing, find a way to move on from that. If I can't have you, let love set you free to fly your pretty wings around, pretty wings, your pretty wings. And essentially, like, okay, like, it sounds like he really loved this person, right? Or whoever the subject the song is about. But again, things did not go well. Things didn't work out. And so, but he still sort of cares about this person, right? And so he's like, you know, if I can't have you, that's okay. But I hope that you can at least, you know, spread your pretty wings, right? You can still find your fulfillment, kind of live your fullest life with somebody else. I Came Wrong, You Were Right, Transformed Your Love Into Light, Baby Believe Me, I'm Sorry I Told You Lies. And so perhaps it wasn't all that other person's fault, right? I think he admits, I came on wrong when you were right, you know, and transformed your love into light. And I'm not sure fully what that means, but I think what he's saying is that he maybe took the love and maybe cheapened it a little bit. I'm not too sure. Baby, believe me, I'm sorry I told you lies. I turned day into night, sleep till I died 1,000 times. I should have showed you better nights, better times, better days, and I miss you more and more. So sort of him accepting his responsibility in the breakup. And then again, that's what he realizes, like, look, I fucked up and you also kind of played me, right? So it's like, you know what, we do need to go our separate ways, but at the very least, I'm hoping that you can move on and sort of, again, spread your wings and fly. If I can't have you, let love set you free to fly your pretty wings around, your pretty wings. Let's see, pretty wings, kind of goes along with that for some time. He does say pretty wings a lot. Someone's gonna love you, baby. And again, that's where what it is. He's like, go out, you know, spread your wings, find your love, because it didn't work out between us, but that doesn't mean it will never work out with someone else, right? So, yep, pretty wings, kind of goes along with that. So, honestly, I think it's a sweet, kind of a sweet sentiment. In sweet, in like, breakups are never sweet or fun unless it's just like both people really need to get out. And I mean, to be fair, sometimes people are at the point where it's like they don't hate each other, but they just don't see themselves together anymore. So it's like, you know what? Let's part ways. Let's be adult about it. Stuff like that. I don't want to say a breakup is ever fun or maybe necessary. Well, sometimes it is good. I'll be honest. Sometimes the best thing a couple can do is break up because they're just not meant for each other. But you know, I don't know if it's ever fun or like a great experience, again, except for maybe one side of it if they're tired of your shit. But essentially what I'm trying to say is it is kind of sweet to at least be like, look, it didn't work out between us, but I'm still like kind of rooting for you, you know. I still hope that you find whatever it is you're looking for, to kind of find your love, that kind of thing. So it's a nice sentiment. I think the lyrics, I think it was actually really well written. You can kind of read it and sort of get this story from it. But it's open enough that I think you could sort of project your own interpretations onto it to some extent. You know, I think it is pretty straightforward, but I think there is a little bit of room for interpretation there. So overall, I think it was a pretty good song. Lyrically, I give it 2 big thumbs up. As far as the instrumentation and vocals go, I'll start with the vocals because I think that's really what I think draws me to the song more than anything else. He's got a great, great voice. Not to mention the backup singing. I don't know if they brought in backup singers or if it's just hit, like his voice layered over and over. But man, he's got such a great voice. The backup vocals, I thought, added some really nice layers to the song vocally as well. And then the instrumentation, there was a lot to enjoy here. Really nice bass line, bass groove throughout the song. It got a little bit of horns in there that I thought was a really nice touch. Some keyboard, some piano, you know, chimes and other, you know, hittable instruments, if you will, percussion instruments, if you will. But yeah, everything kind of, there was a lot, sort of a lot of instruments, a lot of kind of things going on, but it never seemed overwhelming. It was definitely very well placed and intentional to really flow with the story of the song. And so I'm giving it 2 big thumbs up instrumentally and vocally, especially with those vocals. Honestly, instrumentally, I can kind of leave it or take it. It was nice. It was enjoyable. But again, the big draw to me here are those vocals. He's got a great, great voice. So 2 big thumbs up for me. As far as replay value goes, again, this is where I have to be fully honest. This is not exactly the type of music that I typically listen to, but I did enjoy it. And so I do think I'm going to put it on my playlist. Do I listen to it all the time? No, probably not. It's not exactly, again, my type of music. But I recognize talent, and I recognize when I enjoy something, even if it's not kind of what I normally listen to. And so, honestly, I'm excited to listen to this one again. It was a good song. I'm going to give it a thumb up for replay value. Overall, a good song. Really enjoying this series. Again, getting to step out of my comfort zone and try out new things. And so, hey, we'll do another one from Maxwell before we move on to the next song, or next album, I should say. So, hey, if you enjoyed the music, go support the artists, go listen to their music wherever you can. And if you enjoy what you saw here today with, you know, me, do all the normal stuff you do on YouTube if you'd like to support the channel. You know, things like liking, subscribing, commenting with your requests, because that's how I get most of my videos, are your requests. And yeah, I think that's going to be it. Thank you so much for watching, and I hope to see you guys in the next one. Bye for now.